All right, guys, we're back, obviously. I got to do some parts swapping on this, and it's not a lot, to be honest with you. We've got, you know, all the loose nuts and bolts that we stuck back in the block, you know, some motor mounts. Really not a lot on this thing. Got to take one coil pack off that, fix one exhaust manifold bolt. See, this one's got a broken bolt too, but we'll steal one of the bolts out of here. We'll just zip that broken bolt out of the other head. AC compressor, yeah, belt tensioner, really not, just a couple items. The disappointing part is that I'm not gonna record it. I'm in a big time constraint today. But in all honesty, I am a little restricted for time. I need my lift back here because of what's going on outside. I had two or three extra drop-offs today that I really could use this because the other bay's gonna be tied up, this bay's tied up. I just wanna get things swapped over, move this engine aside, carry on with some other work, and then we'll pick up and continue on with taking the engine off the stand, slapping the flywheel on it, and getting it back in this truck after I get the training line swapped out. So I don't mean to disappoint, but I just wanted to come clean with you and let you know why I'm not gonna record. You know, just a simple parts swap over. It's pretty, if you've made it to this point, I think you can handle the parts swap. So we'll leave it at that for now. Pick back up when the engine's ready to go in. Alright, so we got everything all switched and swapped around. Didn't take that long, it was like 20 minutes really start to finish. Of course, I gave you guys a little tidbit on the broken bolt there. We did get the broken bolt out, left the manifold right in place. I just took and hogged a hole through it, stuck an easy out in it, spun it out, zipped the bolt out of the other, out of the junkyard, or out of the, you know, engine that's no good, and just put it in here so we didn't have to take the manifold off or anything like that, so that worked out good. Got a new AC belt on there, swapped the compressor. It wasn't really that much to swap over. And then I kind of stripped down the other engine a little bit, took the coil packs off from it. I'm gonna take some more stuff off from that and just stick it in a box to save it. I hate to send that stuff back just to have it go in the crusher. Of course, we're not gonna save the intake manifold because foolishly, when we took it out, I broke it. And I'm a little bit nervous about putting this one in, and we have to be really careful with that, those little dongers or whatever they are that hold the map sensor in. I don't really think they're that critical. You know, maybe in the event of a backfire in the intake or something, might capture it, but typically that's under negative pressure, atmospheric pressure. So we don't usually have to worry about that coming out. We could always duct tape it, I guess, if it had to. And there it is, all ready to go in. Got the flywheel sitting over there ready to put on. We had to transfer our dowel pins over, which is nice because they're an open hole, so we just knocked them out with a punch and a hammer on the other block. Pulled, stripped some stuff off this, the PCV and the fuel lines and the brake booster hose. You know, just basically transfer our little bolts over. What else did we transfer, Hannah? A couple bolts there. The motor mounts, AC compressor and belt. Gave that a little bath to get some of the oil off it. Engine mount on this side, a little bracket down there for our tranny lines. Oh, and I had one bad spark plug wire. Must be when they took it out, it hit the firewall or something, because this was all tore up on it, so we just put one plug wire off the other engine. I think we're in good shape. And then we just got the old engine sitting over here. I'm going to take and yank the throttle body off it for the idle air control and the throttle position sensor. Pull the injector rails off it, just to kind of hang on to those. Grab that oil pressure switch cam sensor. And I think that's it. The manifolds are both cracked. So, you know, taking the time to save our studs there was worthless, because I see after the fact that they're cracked, so I'm not worried about saving those. You know, I might grab that coolant sensor there out of the head, kind of hang on to that, perhaps. You never know. You can never have too many known good sensors around, or different sensors rather. We'll grab the purge solenoid, and not too worried about the water pump. Water pumps are cheap and easy to change on these. And just in case you're asking yourself, can I pick an engine up by the valve cover bolts? Yeah, you can. That's how we took this one off the hoist, just by the valve cover bolts. Finger tight, they didn't snap. I did it as an experiment. It worked well. I only thought it appropriate today to wear the old Chevy hat, just to kind of get the feel for it, you know? I guess with all that being said, gotta take a break now. We wanted to free up our, we had to do this for a purpose, we had to free up our lift. I've got a few things to roll in and out, and hopefully we'll get back on this by this afternoon, get it set back in there and bolted in, and hear this old Chevy thunder. All right, we're ready to get back at it. Get the engine stand off here. That's what I use for spacers on the back of it, so we clear the crankshaft. This old axle nut sockets, the box was full of them, I guess. Come in handy for all kinds of things. Been a pretty busy morning, so we're after lunch now. We're going close to 2 o'clock. Oh, I guess we gotta take that little plastic cover off. I didn't see that. We'll get our flywheel on here and tightened up. Is that form for me?
Yes.
Okay. And then we'll proceed to put it in. So we'll set our flywheel up on there. Get our Loctite working here. Stuff always works good, it always locks right up. Always plugs up the tip. Oh, what in the thunder is going on here? Where's that? You put that bolt in there. We'll get to have to look up the torque spec here. I gotta take my Loctite, it's getting ready to go south on me. Get out, guys. We'll get that torque down. We got the transmission lines put on it. They were kind of a pisser. I should have recorded that. I thought it was gonna be like 100 times easier with the engine out. But man, I tell you, the Jiffy Tight connectors, they fought me to the end. And the ones that went in the radiator, they were a pain. But we got it. We won the war. They're in. Oh, man, there she goes. Now she just opened up. I got a mess. Look at that. It's all over everything. Always something here. Doing my best to remember where we left off. I think we were torquing the flywheel. That is on and torqued and ready. Everything else on the engine should be good to go. It looks like it's hanging there pretty good. Looks pretty even. You kind of want to make any adjustments you can. Looks like it's hanging pretty level. When it came out, it was pretty level. Of course, you know, hanging from the chain, we do have, you know, a little latitude of adjustment where we can rock it and do what we need to do to get it in. Down here, like I say, you can see we did put in the new transmission lines, you know, up here to the upper and lower radiator. You got the third one that runs up to the transmission cooler, which hides behind the bow tie. So we had to pop the grill off, but it's they're really cheesy the way they come out. Just one bolt, the whole grill comes off. Where else are we? Yep, transmission lines all the way back to the tranny. Went ahead and cleaned off the bell housing, so you can see that. I just took a cookie wheel and very lightly cleaned off the bell housing just to get the old grime and junk off it. And then we took and never seized the holes where the dowel pins are going to go, just in case somebody ever has to take this engine out or takes its transmission out. It won't be stuck. And we also cleaned up, you know, the mating surface of the block too. Right up to the dowel pins. So that's good to go. What else? Oh, the transmission dipstick tube. If you had that out after when you did this project, make sure you put it back in. So I took and wedged ours back in there. I hope in right about the right spot. transmission's pretty much picked up as high as it can go. I showed you guys on the last video how we did that with the ratchet strap at the back. I'm gonna try to leave it like that while I put the engine in. It appears to be almost up tight against the body. I think it's up as high as it was when we jacked it. I mean, it's right up against that vent hose. It may actually be too high, in which case I'll just let a little slack in the strap, but it'll be easier for me to manipulate myself under there when we're setting the engine in. We've got to set the engine in on these three mounts, or them three holes there on the two mounts. Give you an idea of that profile of those, so you can see them. Kind of see what they look like. A little different. Oh, what else? We've got our ground wire, I think is the only thing we've got to hook up on the way in, is that little ground wire right there. And that is the one that went on the back of the block with that ground wire there, which was darn near impossible to get to from underneath, in my opinion. At least something I don't want to fiddle with. So once we get this halfway in, we'll put that in. And I think that's it. I think other than that, we're in pretty good shape. The only thing we have to be really mindful of is this. I wish this came off, or there was some way to build a fortress, maybe like some kind of force field. What do you think, Hannah? If we could put a little orb thing. But we just have to be careful. We don't want to break it. Very delicate. And also, we've gone ahead and removed the one wheel, taken a truck and moved it all the way back on the lift as far as we could. So we have more room up front here to sneak the cherry picker in. So you remember, let's see, it was not, it was like this. Remember, the exhaust manifold stub was hitting the plastic cowl over there.
I remember that.
Oh, you don't remember nothing. Okay, young lady. Oh my gosh, I'm getting too old for this. All right, you got to be gentle, like a little lamb, Hannah. Okay?
Okay.
Start letting it down. Very slowly. Okay, that's good. Can you pull the cherry picker back? Start letting it down again. Whoa, easy, killer. Just a minute. Stop right there. Pull her back some more. Can you go back more? Okay. We got a lot of room on that side, on the right side?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna have to go underneath and push the chip pick over a little bit. Hold it too much. Look like the engine's about center now, left to right. Pretty close.
You have a little more room on the right.
A little closer?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see, we can't break anything up front, so delicate stuff in the rear. Snug coming out. Okay, just a second. Okay, we're hitting right there. Okay. Did that just start, did it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Down here. Get a second here. Okay. Down. Jack it up. Okay. At some point we'll be able to rotate it here. I don't remember how far down we had to be. Go down a little. A smidge more. The whole cherry picker in a little bit, yeah? Okay, whoop. Get tension off it. Okay, down. Okay, clear the steering shaft. Everything looks clear over there, guys. Yeah, we're not hanging up on anything?
No.
Okay, just a second here. Shoot, it looks like probably we got the truck engines tip forward just a little bit, might make a little bit of pain. Let's see. Hit our new train lines. Broke those off the intake manifold on the other one when we were taking it out.
Okay.
Okay, go ahead and come down, man. Alright, stop right there for a second. We'll hook that wire up. I think what we got in there, do you need some help, Josh?
Yeah, and I'm having some trouble getting that bracket lined up with the first bolt.
Alright. Let's see. Good stopping point. I'm going to see if we can teeter it right here. If we can get it to set like on a cross member, I'd like to move the chain ahead. I don't know if we're going to, I can see how it's tipped a little. Looks like it's tipped a little forward. Alright. So what we need to do is we need to get our ground wire. That's back here. In the wiring harness needs to go on first, and then this braided one goes on top of it. That makes sense. It's a whole lot easier to get to right now. Solved. Okay. Okay, start bringing it down, yeah. Oh, easy. Just gonna. Okay. Well, I think we're clear of the danger of busting the map sensor holder off. I think what I'll do at this point is go underneath it, see what we need to do, see what we're hitting. We're hitting on something. See if I can figure that out. And then get it in the rest of the way. Get the thing situated here. You don't want to pinch a wiring harness in the bell housing. We're gonna take and run our EVAP line in right now, while we don't have to flex it as hard as we would once it's in. Hopefully they're not breaking it. Okay, so we've got our EVAP line. Remember how we had to fish that out of there? We got that started. Fuel line sitting out of the way. Wiring harness is out of the way. Ground wire. What is this wire? Okay, that's our ground wire. Okay. We are in good shape. That thing is like so bright. It'd be sweet if it made that sound. Alright, you ready?
Yep.
Now, if you hear me scream, just stop, okay?
Okay.
Promise?
Maybe.
Alright, let me see. Let me get my bag of butter here. Alright, where are we? Let's see. I'm stuck on something in your hand. Give me just a minute to figure out what's going on. Okay?
Okay.
Let's see. It's the motor. Okay. You remember the little map sensor thing we don't want to break off?
Yeah.
You just be mindful of that, okay?
Okay.
I'll take it out of your pay if you break it. It's all on you now.
Uh-oh.
okay, so jack it up. Oh, okay, it's not. Let's see, the whole thing has got to go. Can you jack it up more in here without hitting that?
Yeah.
Okay. Even a wiring harness will break it. It's very delicate, so.
Yep, you should be good.
Okay, go ahead and jack it up then. Okay, a little bit more. A little bit more. Man, we're picking the thing like super, super cockeyed now because we moved that chain. Just a second. Let me get my hand up here on the exhaust and it looks like it's tipped that well.
It's really close to the...
It is?
Yeah.
Is it still okay?
You're touching.
Okay, can you touch in the map sensor thing?
Yeah.
Okay, can you let it down a little?
Yep.
Is it... That's not it making noise, is it?
No, it's not.
Okay, we're clear now?
Yep.
Okay, alright, just a minute. I think I cleared one motor mount here. Let me see what we got going on this side. These glasses are a pain. I can't see nothing. Okay. I don't think I can see this motor mount. Yeah, I can. Yeah, we're like super, super crooked. Okay. Let's see what we can do. We might have to move that chain back. Maybe. Give me a second. Get my light situated. Okay. Oh.
I'm also going to need, I guess, can you get my flashlight by any chance? I should have brought both, I suppose.
Yep, 1 minute.
Don't squeeze through there.
Yep, I got there.
Start coming down a little bit. Ooh, just a minute. I'll crush my hand, but sometimes you gotta do what we gotta do, you know? Strap off this transmission a little bit where it's the training's up a little bit too high in the front. Okay. You just hold tight. Tension. It's very suspenseful, isn't it? Thank you, ma'am. Oh, man, it's stuck in my eyes. that. Okay. Let's see if I can reach up on this side. That side, this side is just spectacular. Okay. Is there slack in the chain now, man?
A little bit.
Okay. Let the chain go. Start let it down. Tell me when it's got slack.
It's got slack.
Okay. It's loose.
Yeah.
You could unhook the chain from the cherry picker.
Yeah.
Okay. Leave it just like that for the time being. Gonna leave the one here on the tray. I want to make sure I didn't pinch any wires in the bell housing. That's the most important part. I think we're clear. Appears to be good shape. It's got to go there. Fuel lines. Good here. Looks like our engine mount is lined right up. They kind of naturally line up when you set them back on that saddle. They go right back where they need to be. Dipstick tube is loose once again. We did not break the ears off the map sensor. That's good. I think the only thing we'll do before we button the transmission back on is we'll make sure the transmission lines where they run are good. On the previous engine, the transmission lines underneath were not inside the bracket where they belong because somebody, like say, cut it, they put rubber hose on it, they had run it underneath a wiring harness across the top of the front axle. It was pretty rigged up. So we want to make sure they're sitting where they need to be. And then I think we're good. I don't think there's any reason why we can't just go underneath it, get everything buttoned up under there, and then just come up top. Finish this thing off and ship it down the road. I think we're in pretty good shape. I don't see any reason we gotta do anything different. So that's where we're at. We got our back up in the air. Our transmission lines are good. I took and see they were right next to the holder, so I just went and snapped them in the holder where they belong. Of course, they kind of come around and snake through there, up and around. That's kind of what we're looking at from the front here. You can see our motor mounts are right on. Everything fit into place really well. I'm really satisfied with that. We can see we don't have no bolts in the bell housing yet. So you've got that little tiny gap right there, but that goes all the way up and around. Torque converter spins nice and free. That gap is pretty well even all the way around.
You know, I can wiggle this a little bit by hand and that gap closes right up, so I'm not worried about it. Never ever use the bolts. I mentioned this in the Pontiac video also. Never ever use the bell housing bolts to draw the two together. You'll break the front pump and the transmission if you don't have it right. So always get this, the two mated halves together as closely as you can by hand, and just be very careful. You know, that's why we cleaned up the dowel pins, why we cleaned everything up, because you got to get them, you know, like that or tighter, and then you can put a bolt in. So because we recorded the majority of the process taking it apart, I'm going to take and just, you know, we're going to put it back together in the same fashion. From underneath, we're going to put our bell housing bolts in. We're going to get that all snugged up, so we've got these bolts that go across the top. Let's see, what did we have? You got two bolts with a regular head on them that go on the bottom of the oil pan. So we'll get those in. We'll get them torqued according to the factory specs, as always. And to do that, if you guys remember, we left two of the bell housing bolts in originally, the two in the oil pan and like maybe two up on the side, and then we let the whole transmission down as far as it would allow us. Took the two big bolts out of the cross member, we used our tripod, let the transmission down so we could get up there and do our thing. And we really couldn't even record that because of just how constricted the space is. I'd use big long extension and, you know, fiddle around. So that's what we're gonna do. I'm not gonna record that because, quite frankly, you can't see anything, you know, besides me doing something. And I think we've had quite a bit of that in this video anyways. So as soon as I get the bell housing bolts in, I'll show you guys where we're at. We'll get that crossmember picked back up. I'll turn the camera back on. It's real quiet in here. That's because we're closed. Things got crazy today. And I'm trying to remember where we left off. I had to walk away from this for a while. I think we were putting the bell housing bolts in. I told you guys that we weren't recording it, and we didn't. They are a pain in the neck. And, you know, the more of these you do, the more you understand why, like when you do them and you bring them in, you know, put a transmission in them or something, why nobody puts any of the accessories back around the top of the bell housing. They're just a pisser to get to. We worked at it, you know, we got them all in. There's a clip that goes at the very top of the bell housing that holds the fuel lines. We got that in. There's another one there that, you know, holds those vent tubes that we saw, the two little ones with the little white caps, and then the transmission dipstick tube. We got all that in, everything's in and tight, and bolted back down. And then it got chaos. And now it's 6:30 at night, just like that. Poof. Instantly for you guys. But so we're gonna have to pick back up on this tomorrow, man. Nothing like putting the old milk machine on a simple job, you know, but that's just how it is. That's how it works. And then tomorrow I got to put a, you know, gooseneck hitch in the back of a F-350, and I got a whole schedule. So probably come in early to get jamming on this thing. I'd like to hear it run. Man, I hope this engine's good. That's always the roll of the dice with a junkyard engine. But the truck it came out of, they drove it in and took the engine out of it. And I know that's not a junkyard story because I've seen the truck. So it did run. They did let it get up to temperature and didn't have any noises. So, but you never know. It's just the way it is. We'll take a quick spin underneath it. I'll show you kind of where we're at. Didn't get the starter put in. I just started like getting the wiring harness down. It's going to start recording again. And then that's the end of the show. So let me show you where we're at. So let's see, the cross member here is, you know, bolted back in. We got that bolted back in, both sides. You know, of course, I mentioned that we had to tip that down to get to everything up on top of the transmission. But like I said, you just can't see it. You know, I just couldn't record it. So it is what it is. You know, I did the best I could to, you know, show you guys. But the fact of the matter is, you just cannot see this stuff. You know, all you would see basically is me working and grunting and scraping my hands. So we still have to tighten down the torque converter. No torque converter bolts are in it yet. The transmission dipstick tube there, you can see that's in there. You can see our new tranny lines, and they're all good. I did stick the wiring harness down here. Let me just try to hold my light. So we've got that here, you know, so we can take and fidget this around. We'll get that around after we get get that hooked back up after we get the starter, the bell. Yeah, let me start over here. After we get the torque converter bolts all bolted back in, get our starter back in there. We did hook the exhaust back up, so I had to get that one shiny new nut there. Actually, I had to get two of them. Got that one, and this side here had a nut that was bad on it too. So we got the exhaust all bolted back up. But yeah, managed to get every wiring harness back exactly where it belongs, all the clips back in it. So quite a feat. Easy to talk about, but somewhat difficult to do. So we're gonna leave it at that. Sheba wants to go home. She got some dinner to eat. Probably part of my dinner. Gotta take care of the stove. What's that? That ain't much tail. And probably gotta plow the driveway and all that business. So that's that. Wish we could finish it tonight, but I don't feel like it. And it's late. So thanks for watching. We'll pick up on it tomorrow or the next day, whenever the next video comes out. And hopefully we'll hear it run then. So thanks for watching.